anniversary. Woo-hoo. So we are excited about that. It went very fast. I will say that we asked Penny. Penny has been coming to the church for a few months now and just fits right in like a glove, and we are just happy to have her and her mom, who is also Miss Penny. I got confused at first when she filled out the church directory and she said Penny Penny, and I was like, wait a minute, but what's your mom's name? And she's like, everybody calls her Penny. So we just asked her if she could come up and just share a few words about her experience at the church so far. And so I'm going to have her come up. She just recently joined the worship team.
Yeah.
This church GFO means to me. The first thing that came to my mind was family, because everyone here always made me feel welcome. Amen. And I really appreciate the love that you guys showed me. When I started coming here, I was in a very dark place. So I appreciate that you guys give me the ability to come in here and leave my troubles at the door and be vulnerable to receive the message that God has for me so that I can add to my armor. So I can go out into this world and fight this world every day. And I just ask that you guys continue to show me the love that you showed me, and I want to show it to you as well, because I appreciate it. Because I want to go out in the world and show other people the love that you guys have shown me so that they can know how good God is. Amen. And how he's working in my life and how I grow each and every day. I'm so grateful. I just want to tell every one of y'all that I appreciate y'all and what you mean to the community, what you mean to me and my mother. We love each and every one of y'all, and I appreciate you guys. And may God bless us to continue to grow and share that love with everyone, because everyone deserves to know how good God is. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So next we have a dance presentation by Ms. Donisha. You have seen her before. You know how talented she is when she ministers in dance. And she's actually been teaching several of us on the dance team how to do what she does. So we're excited about that.
My pain is being tested.
So today I'm still not telling, cause I feel that I speed up is a matter of space and time. So here I am, Jesus. All I have is your word. Show yourself to me.
Pastor Precious coming up after that. We are just going to do a a brief slideshow of what we've been doing since the last anniversary. A lot of people that come here for the first time, they're like, man, you guys do a lot. And we do, but we have a lot of fun while doing it. So we're just excited about what happened the last year and what is to come for GFO St. Louis. So Micah's going to start that slideshow. Miles got some music to play.
I'm Amen. Come on, let's give God some praise. 11 years. The devil mad because he reigns. Amen.
Amen.
He reigns in us. He reigns in you. He reigns in us because he wants us to reveal his light. Amen.
Amen.
Give yourself a round of applause. Amen. Every one of you. I just thank God for the 11 years, you know. 11 means the spiritual awakening. And it's a lot of things that's been waking up in this church. A lot of people, ministries that have been raised from the dead, who have been out and lost, and they have redeemed their life back. Amen.
Amen.
The most counseling I've probably done ever within this span of year, with 250 sessions. Free sessions, amen, to our members, to the people that gave you, set free, come on. I thank God for our leaders, amen. If you're a leader of this church, can you stand? We have our wonderful leaders, my mom, my mother, my father, my adorable wife, amen. She does so much. I thank God for you so much, Keisha. Without this, man, I'm telling you, that lady, she does the most, amen.
Amen.
And I just thank God for her, amen.
Her
I respect her. I love her. She knows that she's my ride or die. I'm your ride or die, amen.
Amen.
And I just thank God, amen. I thank God that he's allowed us to endure 11 years. Everybody didn't make it in 11 years, amen. But you know what? We are here. And I got a little praise report, too, because my father was cleaning the church this past week, about 3 or 4 days ago. And after he left, somebody hit him, amen, and destroyed his truck, amen. But guess what? The devil got purpose, but God got a plan, amen. He may try to take you out, but it ain't succeeded because we're under a cover, amen. He tried with my father. He tried with me. He's tried with you.
Yeah.
He tried with you. I said, hey, we got Marcellus in the house. Tell people all the time to bless the Lord, as it says in Psalm 103. Bless the Lord, what?
Oh my
soul. And all that is within me, bless his what?
Holy name.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not all his what?
Benefits.
His what?
Benefits.
He got benefits. He got benefits. Stop praising him on every level. And when you can't praise him on the level that you get, you can't graduate to the level that you're going to go. There's a reason why the children of Israel couldn't get out. Murmuring, complaining. It's always something to complain about, but it's always something to praise about.
Yes, yes.
It's a side to every paper, it's a side to every coin. And you have to choose the right coin. You are the head and not the tail. You are above and not beneath.
Come on.
And if God be for you, who can ever be against you? When you stop praising God, just know that you just got on the wrong side. And it's time to get back on the right side. Amen.
Yes, yes.
When you're on the right side, I can't find nothing to complain about. Because I didn't deserve it in the first place. Oh. It's not because of me, it's in spite of me.
Yes.
That God has blessed me.
Come on.
Blessed any man shall boast. It's not about your flesh. This is about something that God wants to reveal through you. Come on, man. I know this is good. When God is for you, who can ever be against you? Who forgiveth all thy what? Iniquities, who healeth all thy
disease.
Something else happens when you praise God. Your insides get healed.
Yeah. Yes.
That dis-ease becomes ease.
Yes.
The things that you thought was impossible becomes possible because your perspective changed.
Yeah.
You get on the winning side, then guess what? When you turn on FM, you can pick up on everything on what's FM. When you pick on God's station, you can actually start hearing what's in the promise for you.
Yeah.
I tell people, if you want to hear God's promise, shut down every negative door and start glorifying his name. And promises will come to you like a magnet.
Yes,
because it belongs to you.
Yeah.
He gives it to the people who praises his name. I don't care if you was Meshach and Abednego and all of them. When you start praising, the fire can't burn them up.
Mm-hmm.
So when you appreciate God on every level, then guess what? The devil has to flee on every level. I know we always say new level, new devil, but guess what? It's the same old devil. Sometimes you just need to turn up the praise, amen?
Amen.
And as we went through the year, we had some struggles, man. I remember COVID was a big struggle. Didn't know how we was gonna make it. I remember trying to find a new building was a struggle. I remember situations in our family, what happened, it was struggle for. You will have resistance as you go through different levels, but guess what I've learned? In Psalms 46, he says, God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help. Come on back.
Come on.
He's a present help. He ain't a gonna be help. He's El Shaddai, not El Chifo.
Right.
That means that when COVID came, I said, well, how am I going to fix the bills? All our members are gone. We can't even, the police was looking to make sure we ain't have nobody come to the bills. What do we, the church over here closed out, everybody closed, what are we going to do? God says, don't worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow worries about itself.
Yeah.
He says to me, he told me, I'm a present help. You know what that means?
Yeah.
That means this, that when you get there, the help will go get there. But if you worry about something in tomorrow and you wonder where the provision is, well, you ain't got there yet.
I see y'all hear me.
See, when you get to there, when you're present, he's present. But if you're trying to take your mind somewhere that God is not yet, he's here. He's not there. See, let me explain a little. A quarterback don't throw to the receiver on the line. He throws to the receiver on where he's supposed to be.
Come on.
So if you run your route, God will have exactly where you need to be. And when you catch that ball, you're catching it on the assignment of this is where God threw the rock. This is where he told me to be. And so where God guides, he provides. So when it was time for us to move out to school, guess what? The next month, the school closed because we were supposed to be here.
Yeah.
The place in Earth City, the hotel closed down.
Yeah.
Like 2 weeks after we moved out. Man, we missed that. See, the children of Israel wanted to go back to Egypt. Egypt was destroyed.
Why you want to go back there for? It's time to move forward, amen? So on every level, appreciate what God has done for you, amen? Appreciate your wife. Appreciate your father. Even if they wasn't a good parent, appreciate them anyway, because God brought you through this world through them. Honor your mother. Honor your father. And watch how far your... Man, come on.
Come on, man.
It says, therefore, we will not what?
Fear.
Even though the earth
be removed,
and though the mountains be carried into, he says, listen, I don't care if it's a war going on.
Yeah.
I don't care if it's crazy people out here in the world. Praise me anyway.
Yes.
Give me my just due.
Yes.
Because guess what? What I'm going to do for you, they can't do for you.
Yes.
See, the real thing about the different levels of how we were moving up in Christ, the thing about it is this, the really first GFO session was at McDonald's with two or three people with some coffee. And God told me this. He says, the real revolution of the seed would not be televised. It's underground. The real place of where God is dealing with you is in a place no man can see. No, it's in a dark place. It's between you and God. It's a relationship. And out of that relationship, it's going to bud something. Amen? So you see in the aftermath of a relationship with God, knowing that he forgive me of everything that I've done wrong, everything that I've hurt, everything. And I said, Lord, just use me. He says, I'm going to use you, son. He said, but it's not just about you. It's about the branches that you're connected to. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hey,
hallelujah. Give yourself some grace.
Yeah.
I ain't going to be with you long. I know y'all got the May Day parade. Give yourself some grace, y'all. Hey, some of us, how many of us kind of, we got a little bit of perfectionism in us, amen? Listen, man, every level that I've been to, I have to give myself grace. You ain't gonna get it perfect every time. God did not call you to be perfect. He called you to himself.
Ooh, come on.
So when you are thinking that this is about me being perfect, you already missed the tree of life. This is not about you being perfect. This is about us coming as a corporate people to give him praise because he died on the cross for our sins. Out of that exuberates good morals. Out of that exuberates good dignity, keeping my word, loving my neighbor as myself. As I examine the love that went before me, I'm able to love other people. We put the cart before the horse. We say, God, when I get right, I'm going to go to church. The church ain't for the people to get right. That's like a person say, but when I get in shape, I'm going to go to gym. You don't go to the gym because you're in church. You go because you're out.
Yeah.
So you come to Christ because we already know we're some disturbed people. Amen?
Amen.
But when we come to the perfect healer, he heals us. And he gives us grace and mercy and love. And he restores us back to our right mind. Amen? So one of the things I've learned within this journey, and like I said, I'm not going to hold you long, but we got Sister Precious. I want her to do the when we have people come up here and lay hands on people, because I believe she has a strong anointing for you all.
Mm-hmm.
But give yourself some grace on your journey.
Mm-hmm.
Every journey ain't going to be perfect, y'all.
Yeah.
And some of us are waiting for the perfect moment so we can jump out.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I remember I used to see my mom doing double dutch, and she used to be like this when I was a little kid.
Yeah,
and you know what? Sometimes you just got to jump in there.
Yeah. Come on. Come on.
You got ropes and things swirling around you. Sometimes you got to jump in there when things are chaotic.
Yeah.
When things are up and down, do it anyway because God told you to. Amen?
Yeah.
I didn't feel like I was certified. I didn't feel like God, look, you called me. I didn't jump people. I didn't do this. I didn't hurt people. Yeah, I did it. But God said, I'm going to use you anyway.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I thank God they ain't have a lot of cameras in the early 2000s. Amen?
Yeah.
Proverbs 24:16 says this, for a just man falleth seven times and rise again. A just man. A just man falls? Yes. I know I have, and I'm the righteousness of God. And guess what? I'm going to fall again. But as I fall, I know my Redeemer lives. See? When people try to be perfect, they fall. They can't redeem. Because guess what? Everything is based off of you. I thank God everything ain't based off of me. I thank God I can pass the ball to God and say, hey, God, help me out, Daddy. And he'll help me out every time. I'm not ashamed of the gospel. But in it is the power of God into salvation. Amen. Not just about salvation going to heaven. He helped me in my marriage. I can actually say I need help.
Yeah.
And go to a counselor. I can actually say I need help and get that pride out the way.
Wow.
To go to the next level, you gotta get the pride out.
Yeah.
Because pride is not equal with God.
Yeah.
He says, I give grace to the humble. When you're humble, he gives you grace. He says, to the proud, I ignore you. I resist the proud. You can't come with me, thief on the cross. But this man that admitted that he's done something wrong, you coming with me today.
Come on.
I want to go with God. Amen.
Amen.
And to go with God, it's a constant. I know we repented one time, most people say. But guess what? I repent every day. Because God is always shifting me to him. And sometimes you may get off the right, wrong track, amen? I was watching that Apollo movie, and they used to have these shifters where they, and they say they had made about 4,000 different shift things. Because one minute they go into the sun, one minute they go into Pluto, one minute they go, but you have to keep shifting that thing.
Yes.
And keep aligning that thing. And keep shifting that thing until you get to your destination, amen? And ain't nothing wrong with keep on hitting that thing. And, oh, yeah, you know what? I'm sorry, brother. I'm sorry, sister. I'm sorry, cousin. I don't care about saying sorry. I'm willing to move my pride out the way so God can be glorified. Hallelujah. So, know this. It's not about how many times you fall. It's about who your daddy is. And when you know who your father is, you can come to him with a contrite heart. Amen?
Amen.
So it's only by his grace and by his grace alone that any of us should stand, lest any man shall boast. And when I say any man shall boast, that means that this, there's none that is righteous, no, not one. In Romans 3:10 it says, there is no one who understands, there is no one who seeks God, all have turned away. They have together become what? Worthless. There is no one who goes, who does good, not even one. Well, he must have been talking after, you know what I mean? Or he must have been talking, this is after the cross. And he's still talking like this. That means that this, that everything we rely on is because of the cross. And as we trust in him and we come to him, we can get everything and all his benefits. I had a story I shared a long time ago when I was driving down Halls Ferry. I was going straight, this other person was going, and they had made a left turn, cutting me off. So I tried to scare out the way. I was like on two wheels on my van back then. I had my ministry van. She hit me from the back. And then we kind of pulled over to the, AutoZone or auto parts store. I got her information, she got my information, and then she started weeping and crying because she had college bills and she didn't know how she was gonna do this. I said, you know what, hey, listen, that's not bringing the police in this. I'm gonna help you out. I got a guy that, you know, he fixed my wife's car, he can pop this dent out for you, and I'll pay for the expense. Because that's, my heart was like full of love just seeing her. So we said, okay, we're gonna do this tomorrow. So I called her the next day, and when I called her, she said, you know what? I changed my mind. I want to get everything of how much this costs, and I want you to pay for it. And I got a person that's gonna fix it, and they said it's gonna be $3,000. I said, you know, I got hit from the back, right? She said, yeah, I know, but I want to get this to the legit way. I don't want to go through all this little stuff. I said, okay, you want to do this legit? Let's go back to the crime scene. And this ain't, you know, I know my law. We got 24 hours to report an accident. So we went back up there, and we called the police. The police came, and her sister was in the car, and she got out of the car and explained to the police. The police kind of mad because it was a day after. But I know my 24 hours, we got 24 hours. So he writing things down, and she's like, yeah, he got to pay for this, he got to do this. And I'm just looking like, wow, I'm going to do this for you for free. Why we got to go this route? And then next thing you know, I said, explain to the police what happened. And I was just sitting to make sure she wasn't allowed. And she said, yeah, I was going this way, she was going there, and I hit her from the back, and then You know, I got this big dick. He ain't got no dick. And so I just need to get this done professional. And the police officer said, you know you in a fault, right? He said, who, me? No, look at my car. He said, it's not about the dick. It's about what you did. You hit him. And so guess what? Your insurance is going to have to pay for this. I said, he said, do you got any dents? I said, I ain't got no dents. My back ain't hurt. I'm good. I'm just trying to, you know, make sure she gets her money the right way. And then next thing you know, her sister get out the car, start arguing with the police officer. What you doing this way, mama? Police officer locked her up. I'm like, Jesus, this ain't even called for. And then her place was expired. So she got another ticket. And I'm like, I'm gonna drive away like, wow, the love of God was actually gonna cover this for you, even though you was in the wrong.
Yeah.
See, the thing about it is, you don't deserve heaven, you deserve hell. But God gonna give you heaven because by his mercy and his grace, he has saved you. He didn't save you because you was in the right. He didn't save you because you was a good daughter. He didn't save you because you was holy. He saved you because of his word.
Yeah.
And see, that's what you can trust on. You can't trust on you, but you can trust on his everlasting arm.
Yeah.
And see, the thing about it is, he wants to help so many of us. But when we stuck in pride, he can't help us. Because he got to let you work it out.
Yeah, yeah.
He got to let you. And you know what's the hardest thing of being a pastor is? Seeing people in pride. Because I want to help them, but I can't.
Yeah.
You got people in your family, you want to help them, but they got to come to the end of themselves.
Yeah.
You can't reach them. See, the prodigal son, the father did not go in a pig slot with them. No. You can't go in a pig slot with your family. You got to wait till they come to the end.
Yeah.
If you help them in the pig slot, then you're not empowering them, you're enabling them. Amen or oh me.
Amen.
But the ones that do come to Christ, the ones that say, you know what, I need some counseling, I need some help, I need to come to Bible study, I need to come to prayer, I need to come to church, I need to give it up to you. They've been getting the help, baby. They've been getting delivered, baby. They've been getting set free, baby. Why? Because the spirit of you has said, I need you, Christ, and it's not about me, but it's about you. Every person I've seen that have come with that spirit, God got something for them. And it's bigger than what you can even think or imagine. When I came to the landlord's acre, we just hurt, man. You know what? These 3 months been rough. He said, oh, yeah, we'll give you 2 months off of rent. Six. Thank you, Jesus. Because that rent ain't cheaper, amen. See, when you come and you yield and you be humble, you open up the doors of heaven. I just gave you the cheat code to the next level of how you're supposed to go.
Yeah.
Walk in humbly,
yeah,
and the grace will be there for you.
Yeah. Yeah.
When you hide like Adam and Eve, guess what? That's about pride.
Yeah.
That's about, no, God, I'm gonna take care of that. I'm going to do this myself. You can't do it yourself. Well, it already would have been done. Go get some help. Go get some counseling. Go get some deliverance. And watch God really show out your life.
Yeah.
We care more about the outer appearance than the inner appearance.
Yeah.
I care more about your soul than your tithe.
Yeah.
Yeah. You heard our pastor say that.
Yeah.
I got my own, but I got my own tithe. I'm not looking at you as a dollar bill. I'm looking at you as a soul.
Yeah.
That you're going to be connected to Jesus.
That's what we heard.
Amen,
yeah,
brother.
Yeah.
That's another brother that kept it real. Hey, I need this. He got it.
Yeah.
Anybody that you need something, God got it for you in the body of Christ or many members.
Yeah. Yeah.
You have to stop hanging around chickens.
Yeah.
What?
And thinking that you're going to get an ego for. You have to hang around egos to be an ego. Eagles don't hang around chickens. You don't never fight everybody. You fly higher than the storm. You fly higher than your circumstances. You fly higher than the...
Amen.
I don't even deal with the things in this world.
Amen.
What do you think about this issue with him? What do you think about you praising God?
Yeah.
See, we can always activate it right now. And that's the trick. Oh no, the storm is too much. I can't activate it. But guess what? The eagle flies above the storm. And he makes his place there. And this is the thing I've learned. I thought because the eagle had strong, you know, wings, that's why I could fly. It get on the golf train, y'all. And it soars. It don't do a lot of flapping. See, when you see a lot of Christians do a lot of flapping, they do a lot of gapping, they lie. I ain't gotta say a lot. I can just tell the demon to go.
Yeah.
And it goes.
Yeah.
You know why? Because I'm on the golf stream of grace.
Yeah.
And the thing about it is that I remember Paul Goodloe came out of school when I was at Gateway. He said, listen, really nobody has ever seen the wind.
Uh-huh.
And you can't see the wind.
Right.
We can only feel the effects of wind.
Right.
I said, wow, Jesus said the same thing. You can't,
yeah,
you can't see the Spirit, but you can see the effects of the Spirit.
Yeah.
See, I don't know if you can see GFO for real, but I see the effects of my brothers and sisters. I see the effects of my celebrating. I see the effects of people coming to counseling, saying, Jesus, I need you, and they get changed.
Amen.
I see the effects. You see this wind hit this balloon? It's the effects of Christ that changes us.
Yeah.
And when we are bad, based in his love, based in his grace, based in his forgiveness, you can't help but to change. I'm not trying to change. Change happens as I look at it. I'm being forgiven. I've been loved. He died for me. Even though I've committed the worst sins, he still loved me.
Yes.
He still cared for me. When I didn't care about my, when I was on depression, man, he still cared for me. When I had an anxiety attack, he still cared for me. So why did you have the anxiety attack? Because I wasn't present.
Uh-oh.
He's a present help. I was in the future. He was in the present.
Wow.
See, if you think about your future and you ain't there yet, you're going to have an anxiety attack. When you get there, it's going to get there. You look at something without the provision.
Yeah.
Anything you look at without the provision is a walking anxiety.
Yeah.
Anything you look at without Jehovah Jireh is going to bring you into fear and shame.
Yeah.
When you get there, it will be there.
Yeah.
So that's why the Bible says, don't worry about tomorrow. The pagans do this. Why? Because they know they ain't got no father that's going to be there. But you do. So you have to exclude yourself out of worry at your job. You have to say, I'm sorry, y'all. I know y'all complaining about the boss right now, but Jehovah Jireh is over my supervisor. I got other plans. I got plans to praise. I got plans to raise my hand. I got plans to shout when I leave this job, because this boss is not my God. These supervisors want to be your God sometimes. You ain't God. You missed 2 weeks of the heartbeat. The freedom really truly comes, y'all, in repentance. And that's my last slide. Repent. And I got a new awakening about repentance. I used to look at repentance as a dreadful thing, like, oh man, I gotta drag myself to the cross. No, I ain't gotta drag myself to the cross. One of the things I've learned is, I don't gotta keep repenting over and over here if I just stay at the cross.
Yeah,
come on. Repentance is good.
Ooh.
But staying at the cross is even better.
Yeah. Yeah.
The prodigal son didn't understand. And some of us think it's really about him. He told the older son, everything I have is yours.
Yeah.
You could have got the fatted hog today, yesterday, the other day. We cut it because he'd been without the fatted hog for a long period of time. But the older brother got jealous because he didn't understand that everything I have is yours. So it's blessed on the repentant side, and it's also blessed on the people who have stayed with God. But
amen.
The thing about it, when you stay with God, it's not as dramatic as somebody falling off a building and you grab them and you pull them back up. Amen. And we want sometimes dramatic, but sometimes God is supernatural in our natural lives.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say that
again.
That's good. Sometimes God is supernatural in our natural lives. So as we're honoring him, protection is over us.
Come on.
As we honor him, the love covers us. It covered myself. It covered my father. It covered my mom. My mom was walking with a cane a month ago. She ain't walking with a cane today. Amen. Y'all gonna find out It's going to be so hard to die. Why? Because as we look at him, we get energy, we get life, we get forgiveness. We ain't got no toxicity in our body. We ain't got no disease in our body. We walking, talking spiritual, and we going to keep glorifying. When the world keep complaining, we going to keep glorifying. And watch you live long upon this earth. Keep honoring your father and mother. Keep watching how long you live.
That's true, that's good.
My last one, Acts 3:19. It is Pentecost Sunday. Repent then and turn to God, so that your sins may be wiped out, that times of what? Refreshing may come from the Lord. Amen. You know what? Repentance is called refreshing. You know what the word repent means? It means going, you know, the penthouses mean the top. It means going back to the top where you belong. It's the Moses story of going back. It's the Simba story of going back. It's going back. And the thing about it is, some of you, you can still be saved and repent, y'all. Because sometimes we need to repent of how we used to think about how we are. Some of y'all are some walking blessings, and I look at you and say you're a blessing, and you go, where are you at though? Who, me? Yes, you. You're a walking blessing. And when people can see it on you more than you can see it on yourself, that means you have lost your mind of Christ.
Amen.
When you know who you are in Christ, nobody can tell you nothing else. Even, you know what? I'm going to learn something. It's really hard for me to argue with people anymore. Because I know who I am. I can't tell you how much I don't care sometimes. So, you know, I don't care. You care because you keep talking. When you know who you are, I can't even argue the same. I go, okay, you figure it out. keep on doing this by your willpower and think you don't need no help. Go ahead. It'll hit you later. But guess what? GFO will be available for you when it do hit. Because I come to set a table before you so you can eat in front of your enemies.
Yeah.
When God does his miracles, it's going to be in front of everyone who doubts.
Amen.
Like I said, Satan may have a purpose, but God got a plan.
Yeah.
And his plan is bigger than any Satan's imp's plan. He thought he had Christ on the cross. Oh yeah, I got him. I'm beating the son. You don't understand. There was a plan behind that. It's a plan behind the family that you're in. It's a plan behind every accident that you're in. It's here to show Satan that I don't care how much the enemy turns the fire up, I'm in love with God, the man, not his hand.
Yeah.
Y'all hear that?
Yeah.
That's what he accused Job of. He only praises you because you got a hedge on you. Okay, take the hedge out. Watch. He's going to still praise me. The next level you're going to, praise him anyhow.
Yeah.
Don't matter how the storm. See, you can't go through 11 years as a pastor and say, oh yeah, it's all been uphill. No, not all years. It's been some years. I done had surgery. Keisha done had surgery. We done had mishap, things that happened. But guess what? I've learned something. As I praise God anyhow, all of a sudden my limbs get up, my mind get renewed, I get restored. I say, God, what's going on? I should be praising you right now, but my spirit can't stop. It's something that you got in me, Jehovah. What is this? He says, this is me loving you.
Yeah.
Have you ever start feeling good? You like, dang, man, I'm at a funeral. I should be feeling good right now. But sometimes God hits you. He says, I'm going to restore everything you lost.
Wow.
Yeah, that's the right response. Praise God when he shows it to you, man. Because that's the right response. Keisha Jobs, they do blueprints, and she does bids at Parrot. And one of the things I learned about their job, once they win a bid and they got the blueprints all sketched out, they go to like a party or something and celebrate. When they got the contract to build ballpark buildings or any of the other places, they start popping by. I'm like, Keisha, y'all ain't even broke the ground yet. Oh no, we got the bid, we won. I'm like, hold on, what you mean? You ain't even got a brick laid. See, when the blueprint is, come on, y'all. When the blueprint is laid out, I already see the next step. I'm praying you, God, in the spirit. It's the things you can't see that God got for you that you need to start praising God now. So that how much you clap. I'm not praising based off of how much you like me. I'm praising based off of the blueprint that he showed me in the spirit. Oh, hallelujah. And the blueprint looks good, baby. If you don't know the blueprint, let's go to the scripture, Jeremiah.
Oh my God.
I know the plans.
Come on.
That I have for you, says the Lord.
Plans
for good and not evil. Yes. To hear your hope and expect the end.
Yeah.
The thing about it is, God knows plans. Do you know the plan?
Yeah.
It's true. So listen to the word. He said, I know the plans. And then it say, we know the plans.
Ooh.
But to get the plans, you gotta praise and see the plans.
Yeah.
In the spirit, oh my God. I got a revelation. I got an epiphany. I got an awakening. That you're number 11. Oh my God. We're going to new buildings, new places, new things, new temples. And I thank God for what he's doing here now. You know, so God said it in my spirit that this year, all the workers in here, stand up. If you have a job at GFO where you're a greeter, you're a singer, you do something, stand up. Amen. Thank God for these people. Amen. These are the people that make the building, though. Amen. The Lord told me, we're going to have a day party for y'all. Amen. We're going to step on the devil's feet. Why? Because I appreciate all of you all that serve. God just don't serve just to serve, God. When you close your eyes one day and you open them up, and you're going to see Yahshua saying, thank you for greeting my people in the door. Thank you for every keystroke, for every drum, for every message, for every welcome. He's going to thank. The Bible says he got a reward for you. It is bigger than this surface level. Amen. You can sit down. Thank you for your service. Amen. I can go on, but I ain't. Amen. Because I'm going to let Precious come up here, and I'm going to pass the ball to her. Amen. Let's thank God for Sister Precious. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's give her a hand. Pastor Precious. I appreciate you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't even know how I can say anything after that. I'm just like full right now. Hallelujah. But nevertheless, I want to get myself together because I want to be obedient. That was powerful. I needed to hear some of that. Amen. Yes. Let's thank God for Pastor Precious. GFO, hallelujah. When Keisha asked me to come and give a word, I was like, okay, God, what do you want me to say? And I'm in a different place in life to where I don't fight for words anymore.
Come on, man. Yeah.
I used to. There was a time where I thought I had to stress and strain, and now I just believe God. God, what do you want me to say? We're not going to make this thing complicated. Hallelujah. There's enough complicated things in the world. We don't make this thing complicated. But what came to my spirit, I was ministering yesterday at a luncheon, and the word that the Lord gave to me, and he told me to share this here with you guys today, Pastor Wendell. The word is, it's time to build again. Hallelujah. And when God dropped it on me, I feel the Holy Ghost. It blessed me because I said, God, if you're telling me to release this word to the people of God in this particular time, that means that it's time for us to do new assignments. It's time for us to build some new things. And as I was preparing to come here, he brought me to the book of Nehemiah, the second chapter. And if you go there briefly, it just talks and it says, and it came to pass in the month Nisan, in the 20th year, the king that wine was before him and took upon the wine and gave it to the king. Now I had not been before time said in his presence. Wherefore the king said unto me, why is that countenance sad, seeing thou art not sick? Okay, so listen. I'm not going to read all of that. But as we know, Nehemiah was a cupbearer for the king. And you know, when he went, in this particular chapter, you go back and you research, he's saying that he was grieved. He had a burden. Nehemiah was grieved because the walls were destroyed, okay? And he said, you know, I feel like I have an assignment, okay? Because How many of you guys know wherever your burden, that's where your need is? That's where your assignment is. Wherever you see that there's a burden, I feel the Holy Ghost. That's where your assignment is. And so Nehemiah, he could not enjoy his present place because he seen the ruins that the city was in. And he knew that it was him that God was placing that burden on to rebuild some things. So Pastor Wendell, I say to you by the Spirit of God that now it is time, I feel the Holy Ghost. Now it is time to build again. It's time to, oh, I feel excited. I'm excited about that. It's time to build some things again. God is giving you great vision for this ministry. Even God is giving you, Keisha, great vision for this ministry, and it's time to build again. Hallelujah. And even in the area of relationships, I see God strategically connecting you guys to new people in ministry. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's time for some new connections. Hallelujah. I praise God for that. Because I just came into a season to where I was afraid to meet new people. I said, Lord, I haven't seen what people have to offer. Okay, I'm just being honest. But I understand that sometimes when it's just you and God places you in that season where you're meeting new people, it's the most exciting time. Because God can bring some amazing new relationships in your life that's going to build and place you strategically where he wants you to be. So that's what I felt to tell you. And I'll leave you with this. Hallelujah. There's a lot of things that God wants you to do in this hour. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And if you look in the book of Zechariah, the 4th chapter, the 7th verse, the 6th verse, I'm sorry. Then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might nor by power, but my spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. Everything that God is going to allow you to build in this ministry, everything that the Lord is going to allow you to do is going to be by his spirit. Hallelujah. Everything is going to be by his spirit. Hallelujah. And oftentimes I feel the Holy Ghost. Oftentimes I'm so excited because I feel like I'm in a new season. So I'm ministering this word to you, but I'm also ministering it to me. That sometimes when you are a leader and God has placed a lot on your shoulders, you're saying, God, how am I going to do all of this in just one lifetime? And the answer is always going to be the same. It's by his spirit. It's by his spirit that you're going to build new ministry endeavors. It's by his spirit that God is going to connect you to new people in state and out of state. It's all by the Spirit of God. Be encouraged. I love you all. Hallelujah. You want me to do an altar call? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I believe that word, it's time to build again, that was a corporate word for the body of Christ. I operate prophetically, and God often gives me corporate words to give out. And yesterday, I was actually preaching to a group of leaders, and I was telling them it's time to build again. Some of them... others, you know, but we don't have that. But what I'm telling you in this season, you know, don't miss what God is doing. What is God challenging you to build again? You know, so I want to pray for some people. If you come up here, if you need prayer, I want to agree with you. Hallelujah. I want to agree with you that it's time for you to build some things again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Whatever that may be, it looks different for everybody. It doesn't have to be ministry. It can be an area of business. It can be an area of family relationships. It's time. We are in that dispensation in the spirit. It's time to rebuild again. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We've been healed. God has to show what he is. You've been healed. I feel the Holy Ghost. You're not in the ICU anymore. It's time for you to build now. Oftentimes we wait. We wait to get endorsement. We wait to feel like, oh, it's time now. I feel like I'm okay now. No. You've been okay. It's time to build again. It's time to build again. And it's okay. And this time when you build, it's going to be off of the right foundation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, I thank you. Hallelujah. What's your name? I thank you, God, for Stephanie. I thank you for her ministry. I thank you that you're revealing how she sees herself. Hallelujah. I hear it in my spirit. I want the old man within you.
in the name of Jesus that God is changing the way that you view yourself. You know, God challenged me about a few weeks ago. I had taken one of the hardest exams in my life, and when I got done, I went to relax, and the Holy Spirit said, now it's time for you to repent. And I said, God, what did I do wrong? And he said, because this whole time, he said, I've had you this whole time, and you doubted yourself. He said, so now repent for how you view you. He called Abashiya Messiah. So I say that to you. It's time for you to view yourself restored. It's time for you to view yourself healed. You've been healed. You've been restored. It's time for you to see it. In the name of Jesus, God, I thank you. I thank you that her vision of who she is was lined up with what you said about her. In Jesus' name, I pray, amen.
Shut that door and open it back.
pizza is your portion. Equal, but you got to assume, amen. This is breakfast. This woman is so anointed. Give her a spirit of purchase.
Spirit of the gifts, God. She is a miracle.
dreams and visions, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Hallelujah. Thank you for this ministry. Oh, my God. That the earth needs. Oh, my God. I thank you for our education. Are you
I think Thank you. There's so much on the inside of her. There's so much.
Jesus Christ. God, I speak over her life right now in the name of Jesus. She will see everything that you promised her, God. It's like I see books full of things, prayers. Books of prayers. And I speak right now that none of those prayers will come unanswered. Right now, in the name of Jesus, God, I thank you, oh Father God, for new beginnings, God. I thank you, oh Father God, for giving her the mindset to do what you placed on the inside of God, her God. I thank you for her spirit of discernment, for sharpening her even the more, so God. I thank you for the great teaching anointing that's on the inside of her, God. That now is the time, God. That word of rebuilding was for you too. I thank you for the new over her, God. I thank you for new beginnings. I thank you for strength in the name of Jesus, God. I thank you for shifting her, God, quickly, oh Father God, into her divine destiny. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I speak to every spirit of demonic delay that the enemy has tried to place over her ministry, and I speak that it is removed right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Thank you. fulfilled her shoulders. We just speak healing right now in the name of Jesus. I speak to all the strengths right now in the name of Jesus that may have tried to lock us up with her body. We answer it now in the name of Jesus. I speak healing to her body. I speak no more stiffness right now in the name of Jesus. No more tossing and turning, getting to the right side of the bed. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I speak, oh, Father God, healing over her, God. Father God, you're still healing in 2024. I thank you that healing is available to your daughter right now in the name of Jesus. And I speak that she is healed now in the name of Jesus. No weapon, every demonic spirit that is trying to enter in to cause this muscle tension, to cause this, we cancel it now in the name of Jesus. And we speak healing right now in Jesus' name.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Come on, praise God.
Amen.
Thank God for Sister Precious, Pastor Precious. I appreciate you so much. Thank you, Father. I just want to add today, if you have never asked the Lord to come into your life before, or to come and abode with you, or you don't believe, you know, the whole message of the gospel, I'm going to tell you that God has made it so simple for all of us to receive what he's done. Everything that went forth today, the preaching that went forth by Pastor Wendell, the prophecy that went forth, the songs, all of that belongs to you.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Don't think it don't belong to you.
Yeah.
You might be feeling a little aloof or something. But perhaps you haven't really got serious with God and asked him to come into your heart. Amen. And so this scripture here, when I say God made it simple, Romans 10:9 says that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. How simple can you get?
Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
It's a dumb deal. You just ask God to come into your heart, to live with you, and just tell him that you believe that he died for your sins, that he took your place. You believe that he was raised from the dead.
Amen.
For you.
Amen.
And he was up on the cross. You should have been up on that cross.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on.
Okay, I should have been up on that cross. But he made a way out for me.
Hey, come on.
The way out that he made for me, that he died because he was perfect.
Come on. Come on.
No sin. He had no sin. He lived on this earth with no sin. 33 years. And now he was the perfect lamb.
Yeah.
To take my place. So if you don't understand, it's really simple. Even a child can understand.
Amen.
He says, my life for your life.
Yeah.
That's all he says. And you will believe the Bible said that you are saved.
Amen.
Amen.
So I'm asking today, if you have not done that, raise your hand. Come on, faith, praise God.
Praise God.
So we're going to move to the next thing, which is the offering. Amen.
Yeah.
Come on, clap like y'all. Clap like you received salvation. Praise God. I have a scripture here in Deuteronomy 8:17-18. And it says, and thou said in thy heart, my power and the might of my hand has gotten me this wealth. 18, but thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth, that he may establish his covenant, which he sware unto thy fathers as it is this day. Amen. This is the Old Testament scripture, but it stands true today. Because how many of you know that God gives you the power to get wealth?
Amen. Amen.
How many of you know that God gives you the power to prosper?
Amen.
He gives you the strength. Whether you, yeah, and start making out your humble books. Amen. Praise God. Whatever you're going to plan to give, whatever God tells you to give, start doing that now so we can, you know, go on with the time. But I'm going to tell you that some people make money through their physical body. Some people make money through their intellect, you know, they use their brains to make it, okay? And some people are making money through the gifts, like singing, that God has given them, the voice, you know, the natural things. God gives us all of that. All the gifts, the spiritual gifts that you have on the inside of you, He give it to you, and you can prosper with those gifts. Amen. So He wants us to remember that. And so how do we do that? We do that by believing God. We trust God with our finances. Amen. We give not because we have to, or we're trying to pay God back. There is no way you can pay God back for everything He's doing. Amen. But we want to remember, and we move by faith. Okay? Not by grudging heart, not by a grudging heart, but we move by faith. Okay, I'm going to tell you that God gives us different levels that we just move on spiritually. And this, you might be at this point where I ain't giving nothing to do. But I'm going to tell you that God's word is true. He said, you reap what you sow. It's a natural thing that happens in the earth.
Yeah.
That when you sow into the earth, then you reap what's coming out. Amen?
Yeah.
So I'm just encouraging you today. If you are in that place where you're just trying to hold on tight and things like that, or you don't want to give to others, whatever, if you're like that, you got to release it. But it takes faith to release anything. You know what? God gave me a new idea, a new invention, or I don't want to even call it. But He's given me the power to get it. And he had been egging me, do this. And I had to pay a certain amount of money to do it. And he kept saying, "Girl, what you waiting on?" But by faith, I stepped into it. I talked to my son about it over and over and over. He said, "I believe it's God." But there's something that Pastor Precious said today, that is something that God has given me to do. Because it's on me. It's my responsibility. Because
yeah.
He knows what He wants to do with finances.
Yeah.
Amen. And I just think I've always been able to make money, y'all. God always gives me ideas to make money, okay? I ain't gonna lie. But the money is not for just me. It's for the people, the lost people in the world.
Yeah.
Amen.
And I'm telling y'all, you don't hold. Because God's taking us somewhere.
Yeah.
Now, these are the ways you can give, Cash App. If you got your phones and you want to do it that way, gfosanglouis.com, you can go there as well. And then we have Zelle, so people call it Zelle, but I call it Zelle. And cash and check. Okay, and make those checks out too. GFO, St. Louis. Amen. So come on up.
Amen.
Come on up, little children. Get on board. I got no music. Yeah.
Right.
Praise God. I thank God for this opportunity to be able to bless the house of God. We have so much in place that God has put on our hearts to do. I thank God for our pastor and first lady. Amen. I remember when they were children. Look, I remember when they were children.
I'm sure, like, where's the water going?
What God was going to do. Amen. God has done a wonderful work in him. I believe you, God. I have a... Okay. Praise God. Hallelujah. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Excuse me, Nina. I think somebody wanted. Praise God. Okay, we're gonna just extend our hand toward the offering. And yeah. Okay. Praise God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the offering that we have received here, Father God, in your name. We thank you, Father God, for every hand, every heart that had faith to give. We thank you, Father God, for those who have not right now, Father God, but you know, Father God, that you would put a seed into their hands
that they may give you, that they won't eat their seeds, but they will plant them to you. Amen. So we thank what you're going to do with this offer today. We thank you, Father God, that you're going to raise up nations. Amen. With the offering that we give, as we give over and over. And we will be blessed accordingly to your word, your spirit, your purpose, everything that you have on the inside of us that we're going to be able to do, Father God. We're going to take us places that we haven't seen yet. Yes. We just thank you, Father God, and we give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, I have a Niner. Where is she? Yeah, messed that up. Is Nina out there? Nina. There she is. She's looking for you. She's looking for you. Y'all done changed the plans on me. Y'all right. All right, here you go, sister. Who didn't catch me? Hi, everybody. I'm Nina Coffey. And I've been in this church since 2017. Even though I moved away, I still come back. And the armor you need is right here. If you need great examples of how to be somebody with Christ, Keisha, the first lady. I thought the first lady, y'all were saying. Wendell, when I met Wendell 2017 at the job with the senior services, according to Rhythm, and he trained me for 3 days. And I told him, I said, you should be the pastor. And he invited me to come here, not knowing that he was already a pastor. But I was a non-believer. Mm-hmm. And you wrestle with yourself a lot when you don't have belief.
Right.
But if you don't have a relationship with God,
come on now, yeah,
spiritual.
Woo! Thank you, Lord.
Yes. You will be lost. Yeah. If you don't know nothing or lost in the world, but you really lost when you don't have grace with God.
Yeah.
So that armor I needed when I met them to be able to bench off and go to another place. And even though I haven't met a church nowhere else like this, because they truly teach you the love of God.
Yeah.
When I would talk to the first lady, she would say, you ain't in church, you ain't in church. I'd say, And she'd say, you better go somewhere and get the word and worship with the people. So to have that kind of concern of others, that's what her husband possess, the care of others, putting others before them. And you see it in their parents.
Yeah.
And I thank God for the parents.
Amen.
And I thank God to keep and have strength for them to continue to show others who they are. Because it's not a mask. It's not nothing but the love of God. And they accept and I thank them for accepting my family. I thank my family for coming behind me. Seeing what this church has done for me. And doing for my family. They really, really, really are just what they portray and accept. And you think that it gives you positive motivation for yourself. This church is a good church. The outreach, Grace Family Church. The word is good. Even when you don't do right, and they know you don't do right. They know. Believe me, these people are anointed. Amen. For real, every time I come up to this altar and be prayed for, it comes to pass.
Amen.
And I give it to my family. Keep the faith. I love my sister so much.
Amen.
So much. And I pray that she keep coming here. Keep coming, keep coming, keep coming. Don't turn your back, because they'll never turn their back on y'all. I don't care. You go on money. And they ain't gonna turn they're not gonna turn their back on. This is an anointed place. Believe that. If you don't have a belief in God, if you don't believe that they're praying and speaking in the tongues and the touching of the hands and people standing behind you praying with you, these people pray with you. And they teach you how to pray. Because I didn't know how to pray. I knew about God. I knew that you should do this and you should do that. But Keisha mother taught in the coming to the Wednesday prayer. This is how you pray. This is, be detailed, very detailed about what you want and how you want it, how you see it. And it'll come. It might not be exactly what you want. It probably be more than what you asked for. But yeah, I love y'all to death and always keeping me abreast of what's going on, even though I'm not in St. Louis. I know everything be going on there. And I thank y'all, and I thank Keisha and Wendell for always being who y'all are.
Amen.
And thanks for being a great example for everybody in this church and in the world. And the world will be a better place if we all can come together all the time in a positive manner.
Amen.
All right. Thank you so much, Diana. So now we're going to do a quick presentation.
All right. She
hey, Nina, can you come back up for me, please? So, Ms. Sharon is right. You have to be patient. Kalaya, can you come out, please?
Can you come on up, Wendell or Brandon?
Yeah.
Come on up, So, Nina is going to present the beautiful gift that we have for you. So, this is the balloons and flowers. And we have a beautiful gift for both of you all inside.
Okay.
Would you like for them to open it so they can see what it is?
Yeah.
We can do it later.
Yeah.
Okay, we can do it later.
Okay,
I won't tell them what it is.
Also,
so my presentation to you, I want to tell you how much I love y'all.
I love y'all
so much. And I just wanted to say how much GFO has affected my life. I wasn't here at the beginning of 11 years, but I came kind of midway. And I remember as being a little girl, seeing my beautiful aunt, where's she at? Always representing the Lord to our family. And I remember when I became an adult and I had my own family, I wanted to be like her. And my cousin Keisha, being the first lady of the church, has been such a great example to all of us as women, mentoring to us, talking with us, giving us amazing wisdom, just being there for there, being there for us. And then Brandon you, I've said it before and I'll never get tired of saying it. You were such an amazing blessing to our family. I love you. I love your competitive spirit. But I just love how you minister to all the men in this church. How you just, you are a very busy man. You are.
But I will say this for a fact. When you are in the face of women, nobody else matters. He gives you all of his attention.
Yes, he does.
And I just love that about him so much. So the combination of the two, I just love how the Lord has you guys just being over this church, feeding into us, loving into us. And I just think I let this church be the church for my entire family is serving, my son is serving, the greeters, and my friend serving over there. And so I just thank God for y'all. Y'all are such a blessing to this community and to the community outside of this church. So,
I appreciate you.
With that being said, happy 11th anniversary.
Oh,
and we wanted to present this beautiful love offering. It's over. We were able to raise over $1,000 for you guys. Thank you all.
Man, I love y'all so much.
We love you too.
And like Lee said, I do got time for y'all. I got time today too. Amen. And so I just let you know I just love y'all. You know, it's a genuine love that comes from the heart. And I'm here because God has placed me here for an assignment. But as that assignment happens, man, I tell you, I just love fellowshipping with y'all, speaking over your life. And I just can't wait to see what God will do through each and every one of you. Amen.
Amen.
And I just also want to thank you all. You know, it wouldn't be a GFO of St. Louis without you guys. And so, like he said, we just appreciate you all, love you all, just seeing the church grow and the families that are coming and being changed and people like just taking things and just running with it, you know, things that we can't do because we can't be everywhere at one time. Penny, I think she had to leave, but what she said to me, she's like, are you okay? You have a really intense look on your face. I said, oh, you haven't been here long enough. We got a busy day face and I'm focused. I'm better now. But it's just, we always have a lot going on, but it's fun to me. And it's exciting, and it's the only place that I want to be. So we love you, and thank you for the appreciation gift. That'll come in handy on vacation. So we're excited to get a little bit of rest time coming up, but I want to tell you that the message is coming forth next week. You do not want to miss that message. It's going to be a powerful message, so please make sure you come.
I also want to give a shout. I know Brother Anthony, he's on his 4-year anniversary with his lovely wife.
Yeah.
It just so happened to fall. He already had his schedule that he was on vacation, but I really appreciate him, even though he's not here today. Y'all know how much he does for the worship team. So, and then we dismiss.
I just have a few announcements, okay. And then we're dismissing. Also, I forgot to acknowledge that she was here last week, but my mom is here again today. Miss Joyce, and she, like Lisa was saying, Shay, just instrumental in everything that God has done in my life. And so, if you haven't got a chance to meet her, please meet her. She's so sweet. And she will, like she said, teach you how to pray. So, a few announcements. They had to leave, but this was Tony's last Sunday. So she's a traveling nurse, and she's moving back to Virginia. And so Tony was sitting right here on the front row with the pink hair. So this was her last Sunday. She's in our group chat, so we'll say our goodbyes to her. But just like me, Nina, she comes back to visit and checks in, let us know how she's doing. So there would be no Bible study this Wednesday on Zoom. And then the last announcement before we dismiss, and then we have just like some finger foods. They have a new beginnings class today, so we didn't do our traditional food day downstairs. We wanted to make sure they were able to get right into their class. So we just have some finger foods out in the lobby as you guys are leaving. Just be careful with the food since we're up here instead of downstairs. So 11 years, and we are finally going to do some t-shirts. If I can have Kalia help me. We're going to finally do some GFO t-shirts. Did Kalia leave? Oh, there she goes. So what we did, we have about 8 or 9 designs, and I want to thank Jamie and Marie for helping me come up with designs, because most of it has been me being indecisive about what we should do. So we have some designs that we're going to have on this back table, and then there's a voting sheet, and we want you guys to just, and there's a number on each clipboard. So we just want you to go to the back and say which t-shirt you like, and then we'll do pre-orders later. So we're finally getting a GFO St. Louis t-shirt. Anyway, so we're going to go ahead and dismiss. If you guys can stand up, we'll pray out and dismiss. Thank you again for an awesome service. The game night, the family night was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I heard some people saying they were a little bit sore, but it was good.
A little bit.
Happy birthday, AJ and Marley. And AJ, you came in first, Legend Tech.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. That's a new generation.
Right.
All right. Okay, so Father, we just thank you for this awesome service. Thank you for everyone here, Lord. Thank you that you just continue to cover us by your grace and mercy. Thank you for your angels, Lord, that have never left our side, Lord. Thank you that you are good, and we just thank you for what is to come, Lord. And each and every household that's represented here, we just thank you for the food and the hands that prepared it. And we just thank you for all that you've done, Lord. We know it, and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, amen. Don't forget to vote for the t-shirts, please.
And the food is a lot.